Now, I would like to welcome and invite Mr. Major Hafeez Ahmed, BNP clerk and freedom fighter, the vice chair of the BNP, to give his valuable speech.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Honorable Acting Chairman, the Chief Guest, Mr. Chairman Dr. Kundutamushar Hussain, our Honorable Secretary General, Mr. Pokulisa Malamgir, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. We are here to celebrate 50 years of our independence, a Golden Jubilee. But you have heard most of the speakers have raised a very viable question, pertinent question. Are we really independent? Is Bangladesh an independent country? What a misfortune that after 50 years we have to ask. We have to evaluate our freedom. A freedom for which millions of people have fought and died.
Excuse me.
I am very fortunate to have had the opportunity of fighting for our people in 1971. I fought under the leadership of our great commander, Major, later on, Honorable President Zaiur Rahman. He had declared the independence of Bangladesh from a radio station in Dhaka. After long 9 months of war, we have achieved freedom. Today, it is very pertinent to ask, what about the goals for which we have fought? How much has been realized? How many goals have been fulfilled? After 50 years, I am sorry to say that the goals for which we had fought, my comrades have given their life, has not been fulfilled. Most of those have not been fulfilled. The war in 1971 was fought for establishing democracy. There is no democracy in Bangladesh today. There is no fundamental right for the people of Bangladesh. We don't have freedom of speech, freedom of association. This book that has been provided to you bears testimony to the fact that Bangladesh is having an authoritarian regime these days. Democracy has been sent in exile. Today is the Universal Human Rights Day. In 1948, United Nations had proclaimed the Universal Declaration of Independence. Article 3 says that right to life has been guaranteed. What is the guarantee to life regarding our Honorable Chairperson, Khaleda Zia? She has been denied medical treatment. An old lady, aged lady, three times former Prime Minister, has been deprived of her right of life, right to treatment. She has been engulfed in false cases. Today I came mainly to listen to the diplomats. I don't know whether they are in a position to speak and open their mouth today. One thing, if there were a representative from United Nations, I would have liked to ask him a question. The judicial organ of United Nations is the International Court of Justice based at Den Haag. But then adjudicates cases between member states. Where do we individuals go Where does a girl like Jumu, whose brother has been kidnapped, she herself, a young lady, has been kept in prison for 6 months, had to undergo remand 10 times for 10 days. This is what is Bangladesh. One of our ex-ministers, one of our former ministers of Khaleda Zia's cabinet, Salahuddin Ahmed, he has been kidnapped by agencies from Dhaka and he has been found in India, Shillong. A journalist, Shafiqul Islam Qadir, has been kidnapped from Greater Pune area, has been found in India. He has been thrown in the border. Even after being kidnapped, we cannot die on our own soil. We are taken to a foreign country, left to die here, unattended by any relations, face all unknown people. This is what is Bangladesh today. The ladies who sat there, if you listen to their stories, you will not be able to check tears. If Khaleda Zia's condition is this, what about others, a common citizen? What kind of treatment is meted out to them? Human rights violation is taking place every day. The International Court of Justice will adjudicate cases between member states. But the European Court of Justice has recently agreed to take up cases, entertain applications from individuals. Their grievances are being looked after. I wish the member of the United Nations were here, I would have asked him, please form an organization under the auspices of United Nations so that countries like Bangladesh, individuals like Jumur and others can knock at their door, can seek justice for these unforced disappearances, extrajudicial killing. Many of us sitting in this line, we had contested last election in 2018, the last parliament election. None of us were allowed to get out of the house. I have been elected to the parliament 6 times. In the last election in 2018, December 2018, I could not come out of my house. The police in that area, they surrounded my house. Armed hooligans from the ruling party, they were also there. And I just could not come out of my house even on the election day, could not cast my own vote. Person second sitting next to me, Mahmoudin Kokon, he was shot on the election day by the police. Many of us had to face that event. This is how Bangladesh goes on. This is how the government says that this is the role model for development in the whole world. What is development? You have just heard about a minister who has been allowed by the state machinery to leave Bangladesh last night. The incident which was viral had taken place 2 years back. Think of the women folk, think of the ladies who were raped by this criminal for the last 2 years. If this is the state of affairs, if this is the conduct of a minister, what kind of government we are having today in Bangladesh? Anyway, there are other speakers. All I would like to say, আমি শুধু এইটুকু বলতে চাই, আমি একজন ক্ষুদ্র মুক্তিযোদ্ধা, যুদ্ধে আহত হয়েছিলাম, আমার সঙ্গী সাথীরা অনেকে জীবন দিয়েছে, আমার কমান্ডার মেজর জিয়াউর রহমানকে নির্মমভাবে হত্যা করা হয়েছে, যে আদর্শ সামনে রেখে আমরা যুদ্ধ করেছিলাম, যে লক্ষ্য অর্জনের জন্য কোটি কোটি মানুষ আত্মত্যাগ করেছে, বাংলাদেশ একটি ব্যর্থ রাষ্ট্রে পরিণত হয়েছে, আমাদের সেই মুক্তিযুদ্ধের চেতনা মোটেও বাস্তবায়িত হয় নাই, এই দেশে আমাদের কোনো ভোটিং রাইট নাই, হিউম্যান রাইট নেই, কোনো কিছুই নেই। একটু আগে বক্তৃতা দিলে ইলিয়াস আলীর ছেলে ব্যারিস্টার আপনার ইলিয়াস ওয়াজ লাইক মাই ইয়াঙ্গার ব্রাদার আমার ছোট ভাইয়ের মতো ছিল অত্যন্ত তুমুল জনপ্রিয় একজন নেতা তাকে কি কারণে এভাবে গুম করা তার জবাব আজ পর্যন্ত আমরা পাইনি এক দুঃশাসনের মধ্যেই আমরা দিন কাটাচ্ছি আমরা আশা করি আন্তর্জাতিক কমিউনিটি বিশেষ করে জাতিসংঘ আমাদের এই দুর্বিষহ জীবনের কথা আন্তর্জাতিক ফোরামে তুলে ধরবেন এবং আমরা এর প্রতিকার চাই তাহলে আমাদের এই স্বাধীনতা অর্থবহ হবে